Hey buddy, India is going to be fourth country to achieve a soft landing on the moon.
But hey, do you know what Lord Shiva says? He says even the root and pure substances cannot stay in the space, and no human can ever touch the moon. Hope they remember their Vedas.
Hello everyone, this is Rajiv and welcome back to our channel, The Teacher. And in this tutorial, we will talk about how to create this Batman and Superman animation in PowerPoint 2019. So let's get started. And first of all, I would like to show you all the objects that I have drawn using the shape tool on this presentation. And for that, you can go to the Home tab and then click the Select drop-down button and open Selection Pane. So these many of objects have been drawn to create this entire scene here, as you can see. So we have the Batman and Superman objects here, and one thing that you can do after drawing one of the character here, like I have drawn the Superman first, then I replicated the Superman and just flip the positions of the object and then just draw the head of the Batman. I mean to say, you can just select this Superman before applying the animation and then go to the Format tab, click Group, and make a group of all these Superman objects. Make a duplicate of this object. You can also hold down Ctrl and Shift key while dragging and dropping to create a duplicate at the same position. Then you can go to the Rotate drop down button and choose Rotate Flip Horizontally. And then ungroup this object. And later you can draw the Batman face and can change the color of the dress to match with the Batman. So the body of the Batman is almost similar to the Superman, so that is why I replicated the Superman and then just change the color, hand position, and draw the head of the Batman. So that can save you a lot of time. Let me delete this one. So this animation is truly inspired from one of the animation by Fran Solo at behance.net. So that is the original animation. So if I show you the thumbnail view of this presentation, then you can see that I have created this animation within two slides. And if you have watched my previous video about head rigging in PowerPoint 2016 using the morph transition and action buttons, but as you can see the head movement of both of these characters in this animation, you can't make this head rigging in PowerPoint using the morph and action buttons. So I have used a different method to create the similar effect, almost similar effect. So let's see the animations that I have applied on these objects. And for that, go to the Animations tab, click Animation Pan, and here you can see all the animations that I have applied on both of these characters. As you can also see the name of these objects here, not full name. If you will hover over these object names, then you can see the full name. Otherwise PowerPoint do not show a complete name of the object in the animation pan. So let's talk about the wave first. So if I change the background color of the presentation, then you can see a background object named wave, as you can see here. So this wave is, the color of this wave is similar to the background color. So that is why you don't see the wave when you have the white color on the background. The wave color should match with the background color of the slide. So let me close this. Let me change the color of this background so I can tell you something about the wave effect that I have created. So after drawing this object here, you can see that this wave is a combination of many small objects. I have replicated the same shape many times and then later grouped them together. And then I applied the motion path. As you can see here on top, that the first animation is of wave and we have applied the left motion path to it. And if I open the effect option property, we are using no smoothness without auto reverse, but we are repeating this effect until end of the slide, and the duration of this effect is 7 seconds. And you must remember this basic thing: when you need to move an object over the slide and want to repeat the same effect many times, until end of the slide, then you should carefully define the length of the motion path. So if I show you the slideshow, then you can see the wave is moving behind the objects but in front of the clothes. If you see these position of these objects in the selection pan, then you can see that the wave will be on top of the clothes. As you can see, that wave is on top of the clothes. So that is why it is moving behind the characters but in front of the clothes. That is why the background color is also white. So you see a wave animation. Let me hide this one and go to this slideshow, setup slideshow, and make a checkmark on loop continuously until escapes. So you can see the first slide again and again, and that way you can notice the wave effect if it is working properly. So as you can see that it is already crossing the Batman, and the wave will not be seen for the Batman at the ending. So you have to adjust the length of the motion path, as you can see here. So what could be the right position of the motion path? So it is like this. I would like to drop this motion path length up to this point when the wave is still on the Batman cloth. So let's see the slideshow again. Okay, that's fine. And if I change the background color again to white and show you the slideshow, then you will see a repeated wave in the background. And you will not notice any glitch between the repeats if the motion path length is matching correctly with the original object length. So that is the trick I used to create this wave animation in the background. Let me unhide this presentation. Now let's talk about the other animations, and we will start with the Superman. And the similar animations has been applied on the Batman as well. So you can later use the animation painter. From the animations tab, you can choose the animation painter to replicate the same effect over the Batman. So the second object is Superman here, 2. So that is the Superman here too, this object here, and it is moving in a diagonal position. As you can see here, the path is a little bit to the top left diagonal. And if I open the effect option properties, then you can see that I have applied the smoothness with auto reverse, and timing is 1.5 seconds, and I am repeating this effect 4 times and hit the OK key. So this object will move diagonally top left and will auto reverse within the 1.5 seconds, and that effect will take total 3 seconds to complete the one rotation, as the duration is 1.50 seconds and we are auto reversing this effect. So that is why, so if you move your mouse over to this point, then you can see that the loop is up to 3 seconds. So it will repeat itself 4 times. And again, if you see the Superman eyes, then I have applied the similar diagonal up left path to the eyes as well. And we are repeating the same animation on these eyes as well. So if we see the fourth animation, that is has been applied on the body, and open the animation effect, I am using grow shearing effect with 105% vertical growth rate, only vertical. By default, on the spin, the both is selected by default. So you have to change it to vertical. And I am applying 105% with auto reverse and repeating this effect 12 times because it has a low duration of 0.5 seconds. So I am repeating this effect 12 times with a duration of 0.50 seconds. But as we have auto reverse on this second, so one animation will take a complete 1 second instead of half second because of the auto reverse, and this total animation will take 12 seconds to complete, and it will create a breath kind effect on the Superman. If I show you the slideshow, then you can notice here right on the body that it is growing and shrinking to 105% auto reversing back to its original position, and it will do that for 12 times. So let's talk about our fifth animation, that is on the Superman right ear, and the right ear is just behind this face here. Let me undo this. and we have applied the diagonal down right path, and it is also auto reversing back to its original position with the duration of 1.50 seconds, and we are repeating this effect for 4 times. That means the one loop will take around 3 seconds and 4 loops will take 12 seconds. That is why it is matching in the end. And the next object is left ear, and we have applied the same animation as on the right ear, the diagonal down right path. You can adjust the path length as you want to create the phase shifting effect, and that is the only way to make the head or face shift effect in PowerPoint using the motion path while adjusting the different objects position at different delay and timings. So it will look like the as the head is moving. So that way it will look like that the object is moving his face, even though it is not happening on the screen, because the PowerPoint slideshow is a 2D flat system and it cannot create 3D effects until you use the 3D objects in the later versions like 2016 and 2019. You can use the 3D objects, but you can't apply the similar effects to the 2D shapes you have on this presentation. So that is why I have used this technique to make an effect of moving head. So the next object is Superman here, and these are the next Superman here, which are behind the face. So when the eyes, the first ear and the left ear and the right ear turns, then this hair moves just behind the face to create a head moving effect. So to blink the eyes, I have applied the grow shrink effect. As you can see, I am shrinking this object to 0% vertically with auto reverse with the duration of 0.25 seconds. I am not repeating this effect, and I have applied the same effect 3 times to blink the eyes 3 times with the different delay timings. The second blinking will happen on 3 seconds and the third blinking will happen on 6.50 seconds. And we have applied the similar animations to the Superman as well. The another thing that you should note is the cloth here. And if I change the fill color of this cloth, then you will also notice a oval here. And I have grouped this oval with the cloth to create the anchor point right here at this point. So when I will apply the spin effect to the cloth, the cloth will spin like this. And if you don't do this and I delete this oval, now the anchor point is right here. And if you will now spin the cloth, it will spin like this. So it is up to you if you want to define an anchor point for the objects. And you can also watch my video on how to define anchor points in PowerPoint 2016. And the link of this video is given in the cards. So the similar effect has been applied on the Batman as well. Same motion path, spin animations with different delay timings and duration. Most of the effects are similar, only the eye blinking has a little bit difference between the delay timings. And in the end, the hand of the Batman just spin in this direction. And you can see the anchor point of this, the hidden anchor point of this object as well. I have grouped this oval with the hand to move it just over the book like that. And on the second slide, let me show you the preview from the second slide. So in the second slide, they move their height up and then again bring down. So for on the second slide, we have applied the same effect like spin 12% counterclockwise, and again the motion path to move the arms of the Superman up and reverse back to their original position. And the spin effect for the Batman hand here. So if you look at the wave animation at the second slide, the length of the wave animation has been shortened to 3 seconds. But on the first slide, it was 7 seconds duration. So when this presentation moves from one slide to the second slide, then you can see an increase in the wave speed. So as you can see on the second slide, the speed of the wave get increased. I have to do this because I have applied the transition timing of this slide to 1.50 seconds. So on after ending the second slide, it should move back to the first slide. But it will only happen after the first loop will end. So if you apply 7 seconds duration to the second slide, then see what will happen. So if we see the slideshow, then after finishing the first slide animation, when it will move to the second slide, it will not end the second slide just after the animation until the wave animation of 7 seconds ends. So as you can see that it is still on the second slide, and now it will, after second second, it will move to the first slide again and will start showing you the loop. But I don't want this, I don't want to stop them for so many seconds on the second slide. That is why I have to reduce the wavelength animation timing to 3 seconds. So I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video, and do subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for your time and have a wonderful day.